happen to something when I say that. Happen somehow. There's something when you say, I know I'm anointed every day, but there's something when you speak that I'm anointed. Come on, somebody, that means something is flowing. That ain't the Lord is flowing through you. Happen when you be anointed, but that don't mean it's flowing. Oh, happen somehow. You can feel good, but that don't mean you acting good. Oh, happen somehow. So it's a difference in the flow. They're just knowing. So sometimes you need to wake up and wake something up and you say, I feel good today. Oh, you got goodness in you, but you got to speak it into your life. You got the same thing to you say, I feel wealthy today. I feel healthy today. I feel good. And why? Because it's important than how you feel. It don't matter about everybody else how they feel, but how do you feel? Because you can't influence nobody else if you don't feel good. Oh, help me, somebody. I don't want nobody to cry with me. I want somebody to praise with me.
God doing it. They don't know it's done. Look at this, it's done.
They don't look at you. They just, they got room to praise so they can feel good and get together. Oh, help me somebody. Why do you think they got dancing in the club? But dancing make you feel good. They ain't just got alcohol, they got music. And you only smoke right when you're ready to go home. Let me get out of here. Oh, help me somebody. But no, you want to keep it fast until it gets to late night hour. Then you want them to slow it down. You look at the DJ and say, slow it down. It's about time to put my money running out. Hallelujah, Jesus. I got enough for one more drink. Say hallelujah, Jesus. Ain't God good? So you look at me and say, slow it down. I'm going to finish this up. And because I don't want to go home by myself. Let me know! If you keep going fast, I'm going to miss somebody. You better slow it down. Say hallelujah, Jesus. Ain't God good? I got to get something to use, but I said, ain't God awesome, God? Because God, I'm going to get back to that. I got to see, look, I'm just doing. See, I'm just going through. It's just like a play that's already been written. I'm just going through this, but it's already said the completion that God already done it. So I want to praise and worship. I want to worship more than I praise. See, most of the time when you're by yourself, you want to worship. And worship because you want to feel this done, and you're by yourself, and you can cry and do everything you want to do, and anybody looking at you, you know what I'm saying? But when you get in church, you go to, you want to praise all the time, because you want to act like you say, I'm living. I see I'm going to act up today. Mama! Ain't God good. See, but the house, when you worship a lot, that means you know, God, you've done it, you're doing it, but I'm dealing with something. So I'm reminding myself in a worship that it's already done. So I come into a worship. Because really, when you're dealing with something, you really don't want to praise. That's why you have to force yourself to praise. Or anybody have? When you really got things going on in your life, you have to make yourself praise. But it's easy to go into worship. Because of praise, you got to act like you feel good. And you got to act like you enjoy it. When the enemy puts you, got to say, thank you, Jesus. But when it don't feel good, you say, hallelujah, glory, Lord, you can have. Ain't God good? And you go into this deep worship, and then you go to crying, and then that's when you this is when you mess up. You say, "Lord, you're in the house, you got everything, but please." When you break it down, then you mess up. Then you still go to a spiritual worship. Praise God, because that's right, how He would not suspect. Ain't God, He hear you, He see you, but you messed it up, and you start talking about God, please. Some people don't know they messed up, and they say, "God, please." You're supposed to say, God, thank you. God, thank you. Thank you, God. Because I know what the devil meant for my past. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. See, complaining ain't been over. Praising times and worshiping God of this time. This is a season you live in. There's a praise and a worship. The better days are over. That's why sorrow's in the Old Testament. They ain't in the New Testament. Because the New Testament is finished. Jesus Christ to pay the price. By the stripes you've been healed. You blessed have the favor. You got life more bodily. Peter's already yours. What God got for me is for me. See, all these things is a praise and a worship. So all your prayers should be a praise and a worship. And then when you press on every side, you ought to come out with a praise. With a worship. When you're dealing with circumstances, you ought to come out with a praise and a worship. Stripes have been healed from every single one of every circumstance. So let me come out with a praise. See, but the enemy wants you to stay in the old covenant. Well, you got to pray about it, pray about it, get ashes on your fast about it. Go out there and burn some woods and get some ashes stuff on your head. Praise God. And some people physically don't do that, but sometimes you can look at them and tell them to spread some ashes on them. Because you can look at the mug. When you look at them, you say, oh, they must be going through something. But in the New Testament, it's joy. It's praise. Because that way you're trying to move me off my solid foundation. You're trying to move me off my prophecy. You're trying to move me off my promise. God's going to be successful. God said, I'm going to live a good week. God said, I'm going to be blessed in my faith. You trying to move me off of Jesus Christ done died and suffered for me. And I won't allow you to move me. So I'm going to praise God in the midst of this storm. Because this storm got to quit right now. This storm got to be over right now. It's got to stop right now. Why? Because the storm is in me. The storm ain't out there. It's in me. I'm confused because something coming against me. And I'm looking at it and I'm confused by what God said and what's going on. So the confusion is not on the outside. It's not what the doctor says. It's not what my bank account says. It's not what people are doing. It's my inner self that experiences an earthquake. I've been shaken from my inner self, but I was stable in God. And the enemy came. And God's word is still the same day tomorrow. And he never changed. But that earthquake came from within. Oh, Lord. And you try your brain. You try to put it to a situation. See, every time there's trouble in your life, your brain gives you the answer. But it's not always the answer. The answer is the word of God. What God said. A word that maybe looked like the word of Cain. It wasn't a stone, but it was a stone when you got it. Why? Because before you knew it, you went back like that. But when you got knowledge of it, somebody said, God, tell me what my feelings. He said, no, because you're messing up. That's why you can go to your bank account, you're all right until you hit your code. Oh, your faith was booming. Hallelujah. And you would have said, let me go get $10. No. I got $10. You hit that code. See, you was at peace. All inside. Devil on me. You was all right because you can hit that code. But the code's still on me and you still feeling good. But when you hit that code, now the machine ain't done nothing to you. And I don't know why y'all talking about you going this side. Talk to the bed teller. You're feeling a little bad. Excuse me, ma'am. I thought I had $12.95 in there. And I tried to get $10. And it wouldn't let me get it. And you digging through the car looking for the receipt. For $10. Because your car don't eat and you don't know if you're going to be able to make it from the teller to the gas station. Oh, that was my. So there's a storm going on. And what you got to know there's a storm inside because when you're dealing with something, people around you still laughing. People still living around you. So the storm can't be on the outside because everybody be running from shelter. But you're the only one acting up. So the storm can't be out here to take you to the situation because everybody in your situation would have been dealing with it the same way. Everybody else, come on, somebody go out here. People dealing with their business, they're dealing with their house, dealing with their car, dealing with their relationship, but they ain't acting like you. So the storm. It's in you. And the brain doing its job. Pulled me something so you can justify how you feel. Oh, yeah. Well, y'all been saying that. See, and that's when, what comes the word today? See, you got to say, today the word is coming because you got to stay in control. Because once you lose control of your inner self, you imagine. You know? And until you can see something better, your inner man is still bad. Because you're out of control. That's what the Bible said, give the devil no room. Because once you give him room and he's in there and he's pouring out things on the outside, you won't work on the inside. So he draws your attention to outside. That's why folks don't like folk elect the folk promise your father. It ain't the supervisor problem, it's your problem. Because when he talked to everybody else, they don't act like when he talked to you, you think you got pride, you can't take it. Oh, God. Well, let me move. So when you lose control of your life, you waiting on God to bless when he gave you the tools so you can be blessed. He didn't say you wasn't going to go through. but he said you're going to handle it going through. He ain't going to say you never got sick, but you know you've been healed. He ain't say you're never going to go through poverty, but you're going to be blessed. Oh, how about why? Because you got to deal with this thing from the inside instead of because the outside will make you get stretched and unblessed. But the inside will continue to heal. God built the body to heal itself. God built man to make a come on to create. Not to say he can create what you want. But when you lose control, you want God to do something that you're supposed to do. Stand still and know that I'm God. Why y'all ain't shout with him? Oh, I almost shouted at them as y'all were looking at me. Anyway. Hey God. So when you now you're looking at your life and you are in a storm. And somebody says, well, why are you dealing with that? Why are you? Well, this. But if God promised, still here it ain't there. Why you ain't dealing with this instead of letting this control you? Because you're going to go through things. And if you lose control, you're going to miss your blessing. Oh, help somebody. See, the passion will cause you to miss your blessing. Because you're not moving towards your blessing. Y'all are now. All the obstacles that come at you, if you lose control in here, and most folks have lost control. Why you lost control? Because you let money control you. You let situation control you. Y'all like said, you let the man and woman control you. You let life control you. You let people control you. And sometimes, you know, sometimes people be mad and they upset and think they control. Well, actually, you have lost control. Because it's not what they said, it's how you respond. They got you feeling like you feel. Ain't God good? Ain't God good? Oh, can I read my text? Praise God. Can I read my text? Amen. Y'all better say it loud. We might be able to pray God. Can I read my text? Amen. Ain't God good? I'm feeling good. Look at you next year, I'm feeling good. If you do, just speak to him anyway. Lie to him. Tell him. See, somebody say you lying. So I heard that somebody say you lying, so I ain't gonna lie. So you go ahead and lie. Because there really ain't no lie, it's an act of faith. Faith come out here to hear by the word of God. And if you speak it, because I put the better God said it, maybe that head can leave. Maybe that back head can leave. If you do the power in the word. A lot of folks don't know the power in the word. So when the man of God says something, they be looking kind of. But they don't know your faith, your healing can come through the word. That was spoke that you don't feel like. Oh, how does somebody? But let's get back on this thing. Don't turn with me. And I was sitting in the room this morning, and the Holy Spirit was, I was doing some worship. And what they were doing worship, I was just listening. Because I was looking at TV. But see, some of y'all talking about how we're doing what they were worshiping. You just look at them. Ain't God good. Go to 1 Samuel 24 and 1. Ain't God good. Look at the next day, stand before him. No matter what doctors say, no matter what the lawyers say, no matter what the situation look like, no matter what people say to you, but because sometimes I pull a stretch at you, it causes you to lose control. Because God promises, yeah, it ain't me. What God say he gonna do, be sure he's gonna do. How many believe that? Amen. How many know that what God say he gonna do? If I wait upon the Lord, he will renew my strength. Will he do it?
Yes.
1 Samuel 24:1. Amen. That's in the Old Testament. You got 1 Samuel, 2 Samuel, 1 John, 2 John. No Kings. Y'all with me? I think y'all didn't know. Y'all didn't say. What's up? Y'all thought I was talking about end of the book. Nah, I didn't miss it. Ain't got here. I'm feeling good. Y'all feeling good?
Amen.
Y'all feeling good. Hi, y'all. I'm trying to. Wait a minute. Okay, we're ready. Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Say glory to God.
Glory to God.
Say, I'm in control.
I'm in control.
Take a deep breath. Take a deep breath. Breathe in, breathe out. Say, I'm in control.
I'm in control.
Because I'm not going to continue to miss my blessing. And folks don't know, you can pull the scripture, your friend can pull the scripture. But if you ain't in control, you will not get that blessing. And folks are out of control with their inner self. Because what the doctor, the lawyer, the people around them have said, and they got attitudes and personality, and they don't know faith come by love. You got to love. You got to be doing it in love. You can't do it in it. Oh, glory to God. Y'all with me? Oh, what did I say? Sister Gloria Reed, I got your mic there so you can speak up the dead, so you won't strain your voice on your birthday tomorrow. We don't want you to get too tired today. And we know you're getting older, so we're going to try to give y'all the help we can give y'all. Oh, look at this. You too loud. Right, go ahead.
And it came to pass, when Saul was returned from the following of Philistine, that it was told him, saying, behold, David is in the wilderness of Engedi.
Hold that right now. Now, David, Saul was the king, and he was out to try to kill David. And David was running from Saul. But David was still in control. Saul was running after him. I want you to say, just because you the victim, that don't mean you have to lose control. Just because you're dealing with something, going through something, that don't mean you have to lose control. Get to that. Saul was chasing David. Because sometimes you want to act like a victim and you don't want to lose control because you're going through something. But let me remind you, if God is for you, who can be against you? If God on your side, who can destroy you? If God don't promise you, who can stop you? You can't allow people to allow you to get out of your character because they talking about you.
Jesus.
Hold in my house.
Amen.
Hold you with me now. Most people, when they feel somebody coming at them, they feel they think they got a right to get out of control. When somebody say something to you, you want to get mad. You feel you got a right to get out of control. So I want you to understand the word of God was talking this morning. He said, remember when Saul was chasing David and they was in the cave. I said, oh, let me look that up. Even though he's the one being chased, he's still in control of himself. Come on, read the rest of my time.
And he came to a sheep coast. By the way,
keep reading.
Where was a cave, and Saul went in to cover his feet, and David and his men remained in the sides of the cave. And the men of David said unto him, behold, the day of which the Lord said unto thee, behold, I will deliver thee, thine enemy, into thine hand.
Hold it right there. Here goes somebody quote the scripture. Be angry and sin not. Here we go. Just because you say you ain't got to be no fool. You ain't got to have nobody run over you, talk to you any kind of way. He goes to the Lord, we'll talk about why? Because David, listen, David was in the cave. But he was farther in the cave.
Yes, sir.
Saul came to the cave because he heard David was in the cave. But Saul couldn't get David because David was demon.
Yeah.
See, you cannot, if you acting like somebody else because they acting like you ain't no demon than David. If you allow what they say to upset you, that means you ain't deep in the Lord. If you allow them to stop you from praising God, you ain't that deep.
Amen.
Say, David was deeper in the cave. So when Saul came to look for David in the cave, he went to rest his feet. He was tired. But he was chasing David, but he didn't know David was father. See, God will hide you in trouble. He will hide you when they talk about you. The presence of God will keep you when they look at you wrongly. You will still have peace in the midst of the storm. God will cause a peace to be upon you.
Jesus.
That's why with you.
Amen.
Because why you justify something God already paid for? He already set it up for you.
Amen.
Why? Because he had anointed David to be king. And Saul wants to kill him. The enemy wants to kill you. And he will cause you to kill yourself. The enemy can't kill you. He's like a roaring lion, seeking who he may devour. Oh, well, he can't kill me, but it'll make me stumble over God and kill myself.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
Oh, glory to God.
Amen.
See, somebody don't know the enemy is chasing them, and because they know the enemy is chasing them, they're killing themselves. I'm worried about what the enemy is doing instead of knowing what God said. And they're upset with the enemy trying to keep trying to run and keep delivering themselves and keep trying to hide and keep trying to be a certain way when they don't know that God is fighting, God on your side, and the enemy tells you he can't get you.
Amen.
So while Saul was in the cave, y'all with me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Saul. Because you can find a scripture. You see, the man who was David, when the reading scriptures were put to him. See, God will put your enemy in your presence. Child, tell him all. Next time you see him, tell him how you feel. When you go to work, you tell them people that you ain't taking out no trash. And hit that closet, they're going to fire you. They tell you that part. Don't speak to them. They don't know. I got to live with these people. I got to praise with these people. I got to worship God with these people. What you mean going to the house of God and don't show myself friendly? What you mean going to the house of God and protect yourself? I come to live from the name of Jesus. I come to praise God. And I didn't come. You can't hinder me. You can't stop me. The way you treat me, the way you do me. But I came to praise God because I'm in control. I will not allow you to control my praise, control my worship. I will not allow you to control my life. You got to stay in control. See that? David's hurry. But tell him tonight, you're kidding. God done brought God to bring your enemy right to you. He lay right there asleep. You can kill him dead. See, but David knew that I haven't made it to my appointed place. And he's still God's enough.
Yes, sir. Come on.
Until I get to my appointed place, I can't touch him.
Come on now. Come
because I ain't made it to my appointed place. See, some things you want to deal with when you ain't around yourself. You ain't there yourself. And you want to deal with somebody else when you ain't around yourself. It don't matter about them coming at you and dealing with you and met with you. You got to keep on moving in the Lord. You got to keep on praying to God. You got to keep pressing forward. Do you hear? take your confidence. God will told you that he will move in your life and you will be successful and I'm going to bless you. And you tend it to the enemy when you already tend it to God. Who in my house? Sorry, I'll tell you that.
I'll
tell you that. I'm going to take it up anyway, you know what I'm saying? Come on, read the rest of it.
Thou wilt deliver thy enemy in thy hand.
Now look at this. People tell you, you say you ain't got to go to that church. You ain't got to do that. God's everywhere. God, you ain't got to put up with people. And you ain't got to do this. But what God called you. What God told you to do. I got to stay here until God gives my assignment. 15 days, I'm on assignment. I don't understand it because it seems like they talk about to put you down. It seems like they're coming up again to everybody in the company. Coming up again to see everybody down to me. I feel like they don't even like me. But I'm on assignment. I got to stay here because God brought me here. And I'm only here for a season. Because God brought me over the head and on the tail. God brought me over the man who that I take you to deliver. And where am I here and make my destiny. And even though you got no one that are talking and never help you. Never encourage you. Always got negative stuff to say. Never got nothing good to say. But David had sense to keep on going. Read what he did. Don't talk to him.
That thou mayest do to him as it shall seem good unto thee.
Look at that. Do to him. To chop his head off. Kick him in the neck. Cut his head off. Cut his leg off and stick it inside his neck. Whatever seemed good to you, knock him out. Because after what he done to you, after how he done treat you, after all you done been through in your life, after all the suffering you done dealt with, after all that running and chasing and going hungry and suffering going through, after all that you've been to cut his head off and put his left foot in his mouth. Whatever you feel like don't justify what he done to you, do it to him. And that's what people be preaching. Girl, you got a right, man, you got a right to it. After all you've been through, after all you suffer, all that hurt you don't suffer. Man, you go tell them, you go do it. Just put it on them. Oh, but David had some sense. Everybody wanna talk about David, but David knew God's way. David knew that he could not touch Saul. David knew that I had to keep on with dad that God got me. And even though he chasing me, trying to kill me, I gotta keep my focus on my destiny. I can't worry about what he's trying to do to me because God is my protector. He's my waymaker. And I better more. He called me and he chose me. He picked me when I was out mining sheep, when I was at my father's house, and called me in from mining sheep and told me that I was gonna be king. I wasn't trying to accept my destiny. You wonder what's taking you so long. You done got too many Sauls in your life. And you done touched them, cut their head off, talk them out, put them down. Hit about high. Instead of saying, no, I'm not going to touch them. Because that ain't my purpose. I got to fulfill my call. I got to keep praising God. I gotta keep worshiping God. I gotta keep going to church. I gotta keep going to church. I gotta keep reading my Bible. I gotta keep praying. I can't worry about how they looking. I can't worry about how they talking. I can't worry about what they say about me. I got God to promise me some stuff, and I'm on my way to get it. I'm going to church. I'm on my way to get it. Every time I go to church, I'm on my way to get it. Every time I lift my hand, I'm on my way to get it. Every time I read my Bible, I'm on my way to get it. Every time I say thank you, I'm on my way to get it. And I can't let you use my mouth to stop you from being on my way. Oh, y'all with me? What else is the real one?
Then David arose and cut off the skirt of Saul's robe friendly.
Now look at this. David went up there. Now y'all know good way you wouldn't have cut no skirt. You would have cut his leg. You see, let him bleed out. But he just want him to know I've been here.
Come on now.
See, when the enemy come at me, just want you to know, hear me, I did it. And I'm going to praise God hard. Because you're trying to move me off my hill. You're trying to revamp my upbringing. You're trying to take me out of my promise. And I just want you to know with this shout that I've been here. That I've been through this. I've been through this. I tell you. I want you to know when I leave out this place, as I leave out this cave, that I've been here. I want you to know I've been in darkness. I've been down.
But David knew that just cutting a little piece.
better stop worrying about money. You better instead of worrying about life's trash, you better sickness and healing. You better should have been walking around saying, I'm healed. God bless me, God moving around. You should have been, but you're still cutting off, you're cutting off a whole scene. But David knew by just touching a cut a little piece off that he had messed up. In other words, I was about to get mad and I'm upset about that. But I shouldn't even let that lie. I shouldn't have let what that doctor said, that bank teller said to me, upset me, that teller. Come on, somebody. Let's say if you can go to Walmart and that thing don't move fast enough and look at it, don't give us the right change to throw our money, we about ready to choke them. I shouldn't even act like that. But guess what he had? He was pricked in his heart. And sometimes you need to ask yourself, why I ain't pricked in my heart? Because some knowledge I think I know, I don't know. People don't perish from knowing. They perish for not knowing. And in other words, sometimes you think you know something when you can't act on something, so you don't know something. You got to know it just because you can remember. That ain't a knowing. A knowing is a reacting. But your definition is a knowing is being able to quote it. But you don't know it if you can't react to it. So when you know something, you change. Some people say, I know I'm a messed up with God. Well, why are you changing? So that means you really don't know him. You don't know God ain't nothing to play with. You don't know God ain't one to be mocked. You don't know God is a consuming fire. So that knowing you know, you don't really know what you're doing is destroying your life. And all you're looking at now, when you don't know, when you come into your next year, you're going to wonder why you're still going through because you didn't know. If I knew this was going to happen, hey, don't we say that? If I knew this was going to happen, man, ain't no way. Okay, so that means you didn't know when you did it, but you quoted it. And then when you get the action to it, you be talking about, if I would have known. Y'all with me? Huh, so that's why I tell people you better think before you act. Meditate before you move. Because every move is going to give account.
Come on,
man. Come on, get a response.
And he said unto his men, the Lord forbid that I should do this thing unto my master, the Lord's anointed, to stretch forth my hand against him, seeing he is the anointed of the Lord. So David stayed his servants with these words, and suffered them not to rise against Saul. But Saul rose up out of the cave and went on his way.
Guess what? After David left, Saul left and went his way. When David responded right, the devil got off his track. The reason why the devil can't get off your track? Because you ain't responding right. You losing control. David stayed in control, and when he almost like the lost control, he came to himself. And realized, hey, wait a minute. And then he told the one that quoted the scripture to him that I should have never touched God anointed, my king, my master. When you lose control, you miss your blessing. And we know later on David became king and received everything God said was his. When you're going to receive yours, keep losing control.